In this tutorial, I'm going to show how to use Vray Displacement. So to start off, I made a little piece of molding because this is where I use displacement most often. So picture this as a crown mold or something. I went into ZBrush and did a little carving out of a plane. That's the easiest way to make displacement maps. If you just go into, sorry, not ZBrush, mudbox, but either one works. Create a basic plane and just start carving. And I just made this little displacement map. It doesn't really represent anything. It's kind of a leaf or some sort of pattern. And I've got it mapped onto this piece of molding that fits this profile right here. If you go into my materials, you can see that I have this map in here. If you view the image, you can see my displacement map. I've left some black on the top and on the bottom so that I can put that on the parts of the mold that I don't want to displace. If you're looking at the profile, I only want this pattern to be going in this area here. So the rest I left black so it doesn't move when I displace it. And I just put this in the diffuse map because I'm gonna turn it off anyway. So what I'll do is leave it there, and I'll show the standard map in viewport so that I can see it here, but then I'll just turn it off because I'm not actually gonna want that as my diffuse, but I do want to see it. An important thing to remember here is when you have your displacement map applied, you don't want to use real world texture when you're using Vray Displacement. So I set it up to tile 10 times. I set it to tile vertically 1.4 times so that it would fit properly into that area that I want it to displace in. If I put it at 1, it would bleed into some of the other areas. And so I just fidget with this until I get it in the right spot. You can see I've done some offsetting. The important one is this one. Again, this is just to get it in the proper spot on the mold so that only that part will displace. I also had to rotate it 270 degrees. And this again is just a basic spline swept along a line. So the important thing with the sweep is to make sure that it's generating mapping coordinates but not real world map size. So you want that on so that this map will follow along that sweep just like it's supposed to. And this way, if you wanted to make your spline do something different, like, oops, if I took that spline and adjusted it like that, you'll see that my leaf texture will still map properly around it. That's a nice thing about sweeps for molding, especially, because your maps will follow that. It's kind of built into the sweep, just like in a spline. Okay, so now let's look at how to actually displace this. We've got our sweep set up. We take a Vray Displacement Modifier. I usually try to use 2D mapping because the pre-sampling of it is much, much, much faster than 3D mapping. Usually, especially if you have a large area that's being displaced. 2D mapping will work fine here. And then you take that diffuse map and actually instance it right into the map for the displacement. If we look at some of these other settings, we can see this filter blur, the amount that it's going to displace. So that means that pure white on my map is going to be 1 inch out from that molding. It's probably a little bit much. Let's try it at 0.5. This molding is only 6 inches tall. You can shift it. You can up the resolution to make it more precise. Another thing to remember is when you make these maps, you want to save them as 16-bit TIFFs at least, because the higher bit image will be a more accurate displacement map. When we got this set up like this, it should be about ready to go. Remember, the important thing was to use, in this case, 2D mapping and no real-world world scale. Let's see what we get when we render. Okay, with the standard render and default lights, it looks like that. It is working. Looks a little funky though. So let me try to adjust some things so it'll read better, and we'll see what we get. Okay, when I set this up on a little scene, it looks a little better. I still have some weird things going on, and the displacement doesn't look as nice as I want it to. You can see I have some things displacing on the bottom here, and that's because my map didn't have enough black space to cover up all the way down to this bottom, so it's actually starting to repeat right here, so you see some things starting to displace. So I'm not going to go back and change that right now, but I'm going to adjust the displacement settings to get this kind of leaf thing looking better, because right now it just looks like a blob. But you can see that the displacement is working. Let's go look at some of the settings, see if we can get it to look better. One thing we can do is make the map. Where is my map? Here we go. Turn down the blur here in our resolution. We'll double that. Excuse me. And we'll see what that gets. Okay, with turning the blur down, turning the precision up, I get a little bit crisper displacement going on. Still not great. Keep in mind that when you're doing this, a lot depends on what your image looks like, and mine isn't that great. It's not really high resolution, and I think it was compressed at some point too. So you want to try to avoid that. You want a higher resolution, save it as a higher bit image, 16 or 32 bit. That way you'll get much more precise displacements. And mine's got some kind of funky things going on. I just did a quick sculpting in Mudbox and exported it as a displacement map. Obviously you can spend a lot of time in Mudbox making a very nice displacement. The last thing I'm going to do is just turn up the amount of my displacement here so it will read much more pronounced, just to kind of see what kind of effects we can get. Okay, Vray didn't like that last render I did, so it crashed my 3D Studio Max. But the last thing I want to show you is that if you noticed in my rendering there, it wasn't really showing these little details in here. It was mostly showing this bright white, and that's because I had when I sculpted it, I sculpted these in too low of relief, so they didn't really show up unless I displaced it too much. So keep that in mind when you're doing this. You can go in here and change the levels of this image, but then all this solid white is going to be perfectly flat when it displaces. You'll lose some of those details in there. So remember, black is going to move 0, and white will move the maximum, whatever you set that at. Anyway, hope this was helpful. Remember, the important things are sculpt from a plane in Mudbox, export as a displacement map, use that displacement map with the Vray Displacement Modifier, don't use real world, and just map it onto those sweeps, map it onto those splines, so that it fits right into the space you want displaced, and then tweak those Vray displacement settings until they give you the effect you need. This is the easiest technique out there for making things like crown moldings and other types of moldings. Hope this was helpful. Thanks.